Hello everyone, my name is Keitaro. We will tell you about an efficient and generic construction for signals handshake, host quantum, state leakage secure, and deniable. This is joint work with Shuichi Katsumata, Kris Kwiatkowski, and Thomas Prest. In this work, we realized the first practical and post quantum signal protocol. This is an outline of our talk. First, we talk about backgrounds. Second, we formalize the signal-conforming AK protocol. Then, we propose a generic construction of post-quantum SCAK protocol. Finally, we report the implementation results. I'd like to start by talking the backgrounds, instant messaging, and signal. Recently, a lot of people use instant messaging to communicate each other. In instant messaging, users send and receive messages asynchronously through the server. For example, when Alice wants to send a message to Bob, she sends the message to the server, and the server stores it. When Bob becomes online, he accesses the server and receives the message to him. In this way, we can send and receive messages even when the communication partner is offline. However, there is a risk that a malicious server may read or reveal messages. In fact, it was revealed that server helped an intelligent agency with collecting messages, like this figure. Therefore, to ensure the security and privacy of messages, secure instant messaging is widely used. In secure instant messaging, messages are encrypted with a pre-shared secret key. Hence, the server cannot access the encrypted contents. In this work, we focus on Signal. Signal is a widespread secure instant messaging application. To encrypt messages, Signal uses Signal protocol based on Diffie-Hellman assumption. Signal protocol is deployed in a lot of messaging applications, such as Signal, WhatsApp, and Facebook Messenger. Hence, billions of users use Signal protocol in the world. Let's see how Signal protocol works. Signal protocol consists of the two phases. First, Alice and Bob establish the shared secret key via X3DH protocol. Then, they start the actual encrypted communication via double ratchet protocol. When Alice sends the message, she chooses a new secret key shown in red, and encrypted the messages and the key in this way. She sends them to the server. When Bob becomes online, he receives the message from the server and decrypts it with the gray key. Then he obtains a new red key. When Bob sends a message to Alice, he chooses a new secret key and encrypts them. Thereafter, they will follow the same procedures. The double ratchet protocol and the X3DH protocol were proposed in 2016. Afterwards, Kongordon et al. Analyzed the security of the signal protocol. In 2019, Alwyn et al. Formalized the security models of double ratchet protocol, and they proposed a generic construction of double ratchet protocol. It can be instantiated from post-quantum assumptions. Thus, we already have a post-quantum double ratchet protocol. On the other hand, as for X3DH protocol, the security models has not been formalized. In addition, There are no known constructions from other than Diffie-Hellman assumption, as well as the Zenick construction. Thus, post-quantum X3DH is lacked. The purpose of this study are twofold. First, we formalize the security models of X3DH protocol. Second, we design a generic construction of the X3DH protocol that can be instantiated from post-quantum assumptions. Our main contribution is design and implementation of generic construction as alternative to X3DH protocol. We have contributions in two aspects, theoretical side and practical side. We first formalized the X3DH protocol as a specific type of authenticated key exchange protocol. We call it signal-conforming AKE protocol. Then we define the functionality and security for SEAKE. Then we propose a generic construction of post-quantum SEAK protocol that satisfies the required properties. It is based on key encapsulation and signature scheme. Finally, we implement our SEAK protocol using NIST-PQC candidates. Then we evaluate the computation cost and the communication cost. As a result, we realize the first practical and post-quantum signal protocol. I will get into the details. We first talk about first contribution, the formalization of SEAK protocol. I would like to begin with the X3DH protocol. The X3DH protocol is an asynchronous key exchange protocol with the help of the server. We explain the protocol flow. First, ICE generates her long-term key pair, small a, and G2A, and the first message, G2X. She stores the key pair and X. Then Alice sends the public key and the first message to the server. We note that in the initialization phase, Alice does not know who will communicate with her in the future. Assume one of the users, Bob, wants to exchange a session key with Alice. He first downloads Alice's first message from the server. Then Bob generates the second message, G2Y, and computes a session key in this way. Since parties compute three Diffie-Hellman values, this protocol calls X3DH protocol. Afterwards, Bob sends his public key and second message to the server. Finally, Alice downloads the message to her from the server and computes the session key. This figure shows the entire protocol flow of the X3DH protocol. On a closer look at, by viewing the intermediate server as the person in the middle, the X3DH protocol looks like a general authenticated key exchange protocol. Therefore, in this work, we consider the X3DH protocol as a specific type of authenticated key exchange protocol. We call it signal-conforming AKE protocol. This figure shows the communication model of X3DH protocol and that of AKE protocol. By viewing the server as an AKE adversary controlling channels, we can consider X3DH protocol as an AKE protocol. This brings up a question. What functionality and security are required to SEAKE? We first consider functionality. We found that the X3DH protocol has an important functionality, that first messages are independent from communication partners. This is because in the initialization phase, Alice does not know who will use her first message in the future. This functionality is needed to realize asynchronous communication. We define this functionality as receiver obliviousness. We second consider the security. The double latched protocol considers the stronger security such that it is secure against state leakage. So SCAKE protocol also needs the same level of security. The state is the ephemeral information that Alice stores until C will receive the second message. Even if the state is exposed to the adversary, we want the session key to be secure. We call this property state leakage secure. We have prepared the required functionality and security for SCAKE. Next, we will talk about our generic construction of post-quantum SDK protocol. We first turn our eye to the existing post-quantum AK protocols. There are three types of constructions, but all are insufficient for signal protocol. The first construction is based on Diffie-Hellman type assumption. It is receiver oblivious, but it relies on gap C-side assumption, and its security level is unclear. Also, it is not secure against state leakage. The second construction is based on signature and key encapsulation. It can be instantiated from well-established post-quantum assumptions, and it is receiver oblivious, but it is not secure against state leakage. The third construction is based on only key encapsulation. This is not receiver oblivious. In this work, we propose a new generic construction that satisfies all necessary requirements. We will explain the technical overview of our generic construction. To construct a proposed protocol, we recap on two existing generic constructions. In SIG-chem-SIG construction, the session key is exchanged by ephemeral chem, and parties are authenticated by the signature. Hence, it is called SIG-chem-SIG construction. In chem-chem-chem construction, parties are authenticated by chem instead of signature. Hence, it is called chem-chem-chem construction. Both constructions have their drawbacks. SIG-chem-SIG construction is not secure against state leakage, because an adversary can compute the session key from the exposed state. It includes the ephemeral chem decapsulation key. Chem-chem-chem construction is not receiver oblivious, because the first message depends on the Bob's public key. On the other hand, both constructions have an advantage. SIG-chem-SIG construction is receiver oblivious because the first message is independent of peers. Chem-chem-chem construction is state leakage secure because an adversary cannot decrypt CA from the exposed state only. It brings up to the next question. Can we make the best of both worlds? Again, let's look at the two constructions. In SIG-chem-SIG construction, signature is used to explicitly authenticate the signer itself. Therefore, no information about the peer is required. And the chem key is independent of each party. This implies receiver obliviousness. In chem-chem-chem construction, chem is used to authenticate the receiver. Therefore, Alice needs the Bob's public key. On the other hand, the session key is derived from the multiple chem session key. This leads state leakage security. Now we explain our construction. As in both constructions, we adopt the intermediate claim. To authenticate Alice, Bob runs chem. It leads the state leakage security as in chem. To authenticate Bob, Bob generates his signature. It reads the receiver obliviousness as in sig-chem-sig construction. This slide shows the protocol flow of our construction in detail. Our construction can be called bot chem-chem-sig construction. We can check that our protocol satisfies both required properties. First, because the first message is independent from receiver's public key, our protocol has receiver obliviousness. Second, our protocol is state leakage secure. This is because the adversary cannot decrypt CA from the exposed state DKT. In this way, we can make the best of both worlds. In summary, we propose a generic construction of a signal-conforming AK protocol based on chems and signatures. It satisfies the Leakag properties, receiver obliviousness, and state leakage security. In addition, it can be instantiated from well-established post-quantum assumptions. We won't go into details, but we also propose a deniable SDAK protocol using ring signatures and NIZKs. In this work, we focus on the initial key exchange protocol of signal protocol and propose the post-quantum one. Combining it with the post-quantum Lavrachet protocol proposed by Alwyn et al., we obtain the first post-quantum signal protocol. Finally, we will report the implementation results. This is the third contribution. To instantiate our SDAK protocol, we use post-quantum chems and signature schemes submitted for the NIST PQC standardization. We pair chems and signature schemes corresponding to the same security level. As a result, we obtain 128 different instantiations of post-quantum SDAK. We evaluate computation cost and communication cost for all of them. This slide shows the results. The upper figure shows the communication cost, and the lower one shows the computation cost. We confirm that all instantiations work in practice. What we found is lattice-weighted schemes, such as deletion plus favor light, provides a good balance between communication and computation cost. Also, we observe that we can realize SCAKEs with various characteristics by changing underlying assumptions. For example, rainbow-based SCAK provides smaller message size. In conclusion, we show that design and implementation of generic construction of signal-conforming AK protocol. Our contribution is threefold. First, we formalize the X3DH protocol as a specific type of AK called SCAK protocol and provide a formal security model. Second, we propose a generic construction of post-quantum SDAK from chem and signature scheme. Finally, we implement our SDAK protocol with NIST PQC candidate and evaluate the computation and communication cost. As a result, we realize the first practical and post-quantum signal protocol. Thank you for your kind attention.